I'm from Africa.
I was born in Tanzania, but I'm Burundian, and I came here when I was 4 years old.
I'm from Central Africa. I was born in Uganda, and I came here when I was two.
There are 54 countries in Africa. It is a continent. Every country have got different ethnic groups. If I take South Sudan, for example, South Sudan is a country out of 54 countries. And now South Sudan have 64 tribes. So you find somebody from South Sudan and you say, you are from South Sudan, you think that we speak one language. No, there are 64 languages.
I was born in Zimbabwe. I speak Shona and a little bit of Ndebele, and I came here when I was three.
I was born here in Adelaide. My mom and dad are from Ethiopia and Eritrea. I only speak English, but our cultural language is Amharic.
Everyone in my family speaks English, but we can't speak English at home. So that's a rule. I only speak English with my friends. That's it. But not at home.
Yeah, with me, my parents speak the native language to me, but then I respond in English. Like, I fully understand the language, but it's just, I just can't speak it.
My siblings don't understand the language at home. So they have to be able to speak English to be able to communicate with each other. But because I was born there, my parents made sure that I can still speak, like, the home language.
I was born in Kenya. My main language is Dinka, and I came here when I was five.
I was born in Sudan, but I'm from Ethiopia, and I came here when I was two, and I speak Tigrinya, which is like a different dialect, and I understand Amharic.
There are three waves of Africans that are here. There's a wave that came as refugees, there are the waves that came as, you know, skilled migrants, and there is a wave that were born here, and each of them has different needs altogether.
I was born in America, but I am Congolese. I speak Kikongo, Lingala, and French.
I'm South Sudanese. I was born in Kenya. I came to Australia when I was two, and I speak Dinka and English.
They are all communion society, which means the child belongs to the community. In all the 54 countries in Africa, child belongs to the community, and the school is part of the community. And as soon as the child goes to school, then your role there as a parent finishes, because that child is gone to the community. It will be looked after there by the community. This is completely different here, and that's where the confusion comes. The child goes to school here, they expect the parent to still be actually trying to support, trying to be part of that learning process of the child.
I was born in Zambia, and my parents are both Congolese. I speak Chinyanja, Swahili, and Congolese, and a little bit of French.
I'm from Ethiopia, but I was born in Adelaide, Australia. I speak Amharic, but my parents speak Tigrinya, Amharic, and Arabic.
Do you think teachers need to know more about people's cultural backgrounds?
Yeah, personally, I feel like they do, especially because our parents have been through things that we don't understand or we've never experienced, and like maybe other kids, their families haven't gone through the same things that our parents have gone through.
They want us to succeed in everything. Like, they escaped from war and everything, they brought us here. So they expect us to be up there, you know? They want us to look after our families and everything, so, yeah. Just that most people don't see that.
For my mum, she didn't get to finish school because she had to get married. Yeah. So she wants us to go to school and be educated because she didn't get that opportunity.
Yeah.
I was born in Uganda, but my background is Congo. The language I speak is Swahili, and that's from Congo, and different types of Swahili.
I was born in Egypt. I came here when I was about three, and I speak Arabic and understand Dinka.
What I always think that the schools are supposed to be doing differently is understanding Africans. And building a rapport with the students is very important. Building a rapport means if you build that, you know, trust between you and the student is open for you. The student can actually tell you anything. And that's what you need. But because you are reserved, the student is also reserved, because, you know, there's no, that rapport is not there. But these kids need that trust.